So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In this session guys, I will bring to you another very important scheme jiska naam hai Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. Okay, or in short you can say RUSA. So let's begin with the session. Let us first try to simplify the objective, and this is the name of the scheme, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. In short, we can say RUSA. Okay, so first of all, let us try to simplify the objective of the scheme. So there are two important words in the scheme. One is Rashtriya. So Rashtriya means what? National. Okay, so the scheme is at the national level. Then we have Uchchatar Shiksha. So what is the meaning of Uchchatar Shiksha? It means higher education. So in this scheme, the government is talking about higher education. Okay, and higher education mein government is doing what? So the government is providing strategic funds. Government is providing strategic funds to the state higher educational institutions. Alright. The government is providing strategic funds to the state higher educational institutions so that they can enhance the level of quality of education in their respective institutions. Okay, so is scheme ka basic objective kya hai? Jo government hai wo provide karayegi strategic funds to the state higher educational institutions taki wo apni quality ko enhance kar sake. All right. So this is the basic objective. I hope the objective is clear. And talking about the ministry. So the ministry is what? The Ministry of Education, which is currently headed by Mr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank. But before exam, you have to confirm about the ministry. And funding ki baat kare, so during the objective, as I told you that the central government is providing funding to the state government, educational institutions, so which means that this scheme is a centrally sponsored scheme. Alright, this scheme is a centrally sponsored scheme. So you all know that if a scheme is a centrally sponsored, then these funding ratios are followed generally. So center ratio states 60:40, center ratio specialized special category states, and this special category states definition is not given in the document of RUSA. So special category states 90:10, while if it is a UT, then 100% funding is provided by the central government. Alright. And talking about the components. So these components you don't have to remember. This is just for the basic understanding of the scheme. Ki is scheme mein actually ho kya raha hai. So the creation of universities by conversion of colleges in a cluster. Creation of universities by upgradation of existing autonomous colleges. Then faculty improvement and faculty recruitment support will be provided by the government to these institutions. Then we have infrastructure grants to colleges and universities so that they can improve their infrastructure. And they can match their infrastructure with the today's demand of today's technology demand. Alright. Then research, innovation, and quality improvement. So these are the things that government will do with the universities, with the institutions in the state higher educational institutions. Okay. And now talking about the things to remember. These are the 3-4 things that you have to remember. First of all, you have to remember the launch year. It was launched in the year 2013. 2013 mein is scheme ko launch kiya gaya tha. And you have to remember something about the institutional mechanism also. Like there are three level institutional mechanism in this scheme. First of all, we have National Mission Authority, which is chaired by the Union Education Minister. Isko chair kaun karenge? Union Education Minister isko chair karenge. And its function is to provide the overall guidance. Its function is to provide the overall guidance for the implementation of the scheme and also to approve the funds. Fund approval ka kaam bhi iska hai National Mission Authority ka, and to provide the overall guidance for the implementation of the scheme. Alright. Then we have Project Approval Board, which is chaired by the Secretary in the Higher Education. Okay, Higher Education ka jo Secretary hai, that will be the, he or she will be the chairperson of Project Approval Board. Aur Project Approval Board ka kaam kya hai? Implementation of the scheme. Alright. Inka kaam kya hai? Implementation of the scheme. And also basically if you talk precisely, so they will check upon the state higher level higher education plans and also check the resources that the institutions have been provided. Okay, and then we have RUSA Resource Center. It is a technical support run by Tata Institute of Social Sciences. TIS jo hai, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, wo ye RUSA Resource Center ke through government ko provide kara raha hai all the type of technical support to implement this scheme RUSA. Okay. And there is one guys, Google RUSA portal that was launched 2-3 years back. Google RUSA portal hai. So Google RUSA portal mein kya hoga ki jo bhi progress hai jo ki ho rahi hai under the RUSA scheme. Agar let us say there is a university, there is an institution, okay, institution A, this institution is doing some infrastructure development under the RUSA scheme by using the RUSA fund. Okay, so this institution can provide photograph that will be geotagged through this Google RUSA portal, ताकि government जो है उस progress के ऊपर नजर रख सके. Okay, so this is the Google RUSA portal. So these are the things that you have to remember. And इसमें भी आपको बस ये याद रखना है, National Mission Authority who is the chairperson, function याद रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. Project Approval Board who is the chairperson and RUSA Resource Center is RUSA Resource Center is sponsored by which organization? That's Tata Institute of Social Sciences. Okay. And that's it about the scheme. So Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan is for the enhancement of quality of higher education in the state higher educational institution. Under the scheme, central government provides strategic funds to the state higher educational institutions, and kuch jo ratio hai wo state se bhi liya jata hai. And it was launched in 2013 and three level ka isme institutional mechanism hota hai. Okay, and now let's talk about the questions that can be asked in your exam. So there is a passage that has been given, so you have to read this passage and answer the questions that follow. So a scheme was launched by the Ministry of Education which is aimed at providing strategic funds to eligible state higher educational institutions to address the issues related to equity, access and excellence in higher education. So under the scheme there is a National Mission Authority in which provides overall guidance for the scheme. So till now yahan pe aapko ministry given hai, यहाँ पे आपको इसका जो बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव है दैट इज आल्सो गिवन. एंड नाउ गाइस दिस ऑब्जेक्टिव कैन बी ऑफ सम अदर स्कीम आल्सो. ये जो ऑब्जेक्टिव है काफी कॉमन है, टू इंप्रूव द क्वालिटी ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन, दैट्स वेरी कॉमन. सो उस कॉमननेस को खत्म करने के लिए देयर इज वन मोर हिंट दैट इज आल्सो गिवन. देयर इज अ नेशनल मिशन अथॉरिटी व्हिच प्रोवाइड्स ओवरऑल गाइडेंस फॉर द स्कीम. सो नाउ यू कैन इजीली आइडेंटिफाई द मिशन इज व्हाट, राष्ट्रीय उच्चतर शिक्षा अभियान. ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर हियर. एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 इज आल्सो based on this. So he is the chairperson of National Mission Authority under the scheme mentioned in the passage. So we all know now the scheme is what, Rashtriya Uchchatar Shiksha Abhiyan. So this National Mission Authority is chaired by the Union Minister of Education. So option E here will be the correct answer. All right, and that's it for the session. I hope this scheme is clear. If you have any doubts you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain agle session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.